this is meadow is getting eroded really, really bad. And I'll show you, I'll get clips of that. And he went and got a grant to fix this and stop this erosion. So what we're going to be doing is we're going to build a series of five incremental dams up this creek. It's all been engineered by NRCS. They've been very cooperative and very helpful. So we're pretty much going to follow their plan, obviously, all the engineering. And Tom and I are going to build some dams. It's a good project, and we'll get going on it. Three trees were dropped wrong here from the bug kill, and there's some stumps here. And I still have one more tree I'm going to skid out over there. I've already got it kind of started. I got these two big trees out, laying over there. This one is going to be part of the dam. We're going to use cedar logs for the dams. That's the plan. The pine ones just won't last very long. There's running water a little bit still, a little bit. It's mostly from a spring up the hill. We'll start here and get our dam in. Now you can see down here in the creek, this is another dam location. We've marked them with stakes up along the way here. These are approximate locations, and we'll shoot the level of the dam in and shoot this with a transit of where the next dam needs to be in height after we get our base dam in. And we're going to work our way up the drainage. These are all logs we'll be using to build the dams. Yeah, I had to do a little bit of cutting of these logs. They were 50-60 feet long, and trying to get them out of the creek with all their branches a little tough. I'm using a steel 046 32 inch bar on here. Great saw. It's a little older, but I've had it quite a while. But wonderful saw. And I'm all hitched up here with my tractor, and we'll skid this one tree out that's left. Some of the scraps from the logs we're using, and we have logs stacked all along the creek here. One more dam to put in tomorrow, and we have five dams in place. We still have a little bit of dirt work around them and securing and things like that to do. You can see one down here. I haven't marked where we're going to cut the spillway notches already, and down in here. This is a three log dam in here. Now that top log, these are over 20, these are about 20 inch logs, the bottom ones, and this one's a little over 20 inch diameter logs. We're using all cedar for the project. They'll last longer than the pine would last. And also all of them get spillways. That's so we can control the direction of the flow. It really just a gentle swale in the meadow here. You can see the meadow. And you can see here where the erosion creep is working its way right up. All it will just follow along all the way up there, just like Niagara Falls has done over the millennia. It's just creeping along, and so we have this large pool right here, and you'll see how it's just eroding away. We're going to build a permanent lip in here with a log to hopefully stop that, and the flooding this here will flood in and hopefully fill with silt. And down below at the bottom here of this, there's a big pond. It's probably over an acre. It's a pretty good sized pond. It's a beautiful piece of property in here, and we're doing really good. And we'll be back on it tomorrow afternoon, and hopefully by Monday. When we'll work Monday, of course, and we'll probably be able to finish up on Monday. Another day on the dams, and yesterday we made real good progress. This is our highest dam here up the creek. This is our last dam, hopefully, And we got it all done and cut out, dammed up, and overnight we got a real nice backup of water. That's good. It's a good thing. Yeah, we still have a little water filtering through the filter media, as you see it running there. But in time, the filter media will block up with silt and plug up, and the water level will come up. Now, if we walk down here to the next dam down, we're having water level rise here also. We have three dams complete with our spillways and damming up, and we're having water level build up here nicely. That's a good thing. And then even our pond that's in this spot is filling, and we have this backing up here now also. There we have a foot and a half deep water here on the big dam. So we're pretty happy. Things are working the way they're supposed to work. And we have very little water flow out of this dam. So things are going really good. We have three more dams to cut spillways in and put in the semi-permeable cloth here to filter the silt to get this to fill in. We're holding it down with some sandbags. Well, they're full of rocks, but rock bags to mold in against the logs to get that filter material in tight, and then some rocks to help hold down the filter material so it doesn't bypass, the water doesn't bypass it. But this is working out really good, and we'll get the other three done today. We should be basically complete with our project hopefully today. So smile and be nice, Tom. So
my best friend.
this is Mr. Tom Seymour. This is the property we're doing the dam project on, and we just finished our fifth dam. Yeah. We have one more to do. One more big dam, well, single log big dam, but we got one more to do, and we're over there and we'll show you what we're doing there. So this is our lowest elevation dam, and this is your most critical dam. And now what I've done here is I just cut about every 2 inches across that to make these spillways down to a pretty even depth, and then just chipped it all out of there with a chainsaw. That's how I've made those. And here we're putting a semi-permeable membrane cloth on the side here, and that is put up tight against the black cloth you saw in the other ones, up tight against the dam, and the water will filter through that and catch the sediment and then eventually block up, and it'll then catch the water and hold the water back. And then as the sediment will build up, which is what you want it to do. And then on this, but this dam here, we'll have a cloth on the downstream side, and then we're going to rock all of this in here on the outflow side of the dam. We'll all be rocked approximately 5-6 feet out and across the just about the entire width of the dam, especially where the spillway is. And that's for the overflow, so you don't have erosion start here and run out into the pond. Now, we're almost at the elevation of the pond here. We're just above it by a couple feet. But you don't want that erosion started here and to form another gully. So this is where they chose, where they wanted us to put this base dam. So we're going to do that now. We're going to put the cloth in, get it all secured. And then on the ends here, we're going to build rock abutments and the cloth. And then, like I said, the cloth and the rock on the downstream side. There's our pile of rock we're working with right there. Nice big stuff. It helps having tractors. And and talk about tractors. So we're using two John Deere's. This one's mine. I have put a backhoe on it. And I have a bucket, and then on Tom's we have the grapple on there for help move the logs and stuff. So that's how we're doing it, skidding them in place and everything. All right, cloth on this side. We're using two layers of cloth we want it to really plug up well. And then we're gonna put a layer of some cloth on the other side also. It's already slowed the water. Well, this is not quite finished yet. We still have all the rock to put in, but this is 2 days later and the water is backing up really, really nice. That's over a foot deep in here. This is our very bottom lowest elevation log or lowest elevation dam, and backing up really nice. This is the next one up the hill, number two dam. And backing up very nicely. It's a lot flatter in here. It was just naturally flat in here. So yeah, it's gonna take a long time to get to that spillway level. It'll have to fill up a lot up the bank. But this is really backing up nice. Three dam, and again, backing up. We have over a foot of elevation there so far that we've picked up. Four, this is our big dam, three log dam, and backing up nicely. It's all, you know, it's backed up into this pond that was here already, so there's no perceivable flow, but it's just filling. We have very little flow here. Dam number five. That's the big dam down there. And it's a short stretch. This is right above the big pool right here. And it has a bit of flow actually here. It's not backing up quite as well as it could be. It's, I can see flow right here at the dam. We may need to bag this a little bit or put some small rock and gravel in here. Dam number six, and we're getting good backup here. And a little, and of course there's some water flow. Not much though. And this is gonna back, this is backing up into the next pool and the big drop, which is right up here. This is approximately 3 or 4 inches before it goes over the spillway. Not too much to go.